Researchers from the International Crane Foundation, together with the community, conducted the first ever census for cranes in the district.
We have to sensitize them so that they can know the importance of the cranes. We also want to tell them that cranes are not a danger to them, but it is because of the activities that have really eaten into the habitats of the cranes.
By press time, data from the various teams on ground had established a total of 480 cranes in the area.
It sums up to 480, and which really is not the exact one, because we have found out that after counting, between the time that we had set, we have missed some of the cranes.
Conservationists, however, noted that extremism of human activities on wetlands has significantly reduced population of crested cranes in the country. According to the Western Uganda Field Officer for International Crane Foundation, Fiona Orishaba, the census could not capture all the crested cranes in the district due to a number of factors.
These cranes, we have found that they have a lot of threats. We have seen that there is a lot of eucalyptus plantations in the wetlands, which contribute to the drying of the wetlands.
She says this is just the beginning of a fact-finding mission to protect the national bird. Orishaba adds that the increasing human activities have endangered the grey-coloured crested cranes.
Of course, agriculture encroachment is a high threat to the cranes. We have found out that there is too much livestock grazing in the wetlands, which really, these livestock disturb the eggs of cranes in the wetlands. We have also found out in the town council where people have the washing bays, where all that water with a lot of pollution that end up in the wetlands.
The East African Research and Monitoring Specialist with the International Crane Foundation, Dr. Maurice Ogoma, says that the main purpose of the census and assessments made is to sensitize masses on how to conserve the nature.
We also want to tell them that cranes are not a danger to them, but it is because of the activities that have really eaten into the habitats of the cranes. So the cranes have to come out because they are being disturbed in their natural habitats.
Leaders and community members commended the efforts currently in place to protect wetlands.
I can see and I can tell that there is great improvement in wetland conservation, crane conservation, and especially the community have started picking why we should have wetland.
That when those cranes of Uganda crosses to Rwanda, in Rwanda they don't have much control on cranes.
Reports from the Ministry of Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities indicate that in the last 26 years, Uganda has lost 80% of its total crested crane population of 35,000 birds as per the census conducted in 1995. Story compiled by Job Namanya for the News in Rutshuga.